Hello students, welcome to chemistry classes. So now we are going to discuss the lattice enthalpy of ionic crystals. So I already told you how these ionic crystals are formed. Ionic crystals are formed by the cations and anions. Mutual force of attraction or electrostatic force of attraction between positively charged cation and negatively charged anion. So during the course of the formation of ionic crystal, certain amount of energy is released. The energy released during the course of the formation of ionic crystal is actually said to be lattice enthalpy of ionic crystals. Now what is lattice enthalpy? The amount of energy released when one mole of ionic crystal is formed from the constituent ions in its gaseous state. So we know that M plus metal atom ionic state in the gaseous form and X minus halogen atom in the gaseous state gives MX. This is a solid ion. Ionic crystal is formed. So delta H naught F enthalpy change of formation for this reaction is negative, or simply U is equal to negative. U means energy. Energy for this process is negative. U or delta H naught F is negative means, so the process is exothermic in nature. During the course of the process, certain amount of energy is released. But in actual practice, lattice enthalpy is on, otherwise we explain when ionic crystals exist in the solid state, how to dissociate the ionic crystal into constituent ions. That is very difficult. We can't able to dissociate this MX into M plus and X minus. For such cases, we supply certain amount of energy. So that is amount of energy required to dissociate one mole of solid ionic crystals in its gaseous state to its constituent ions, ions, cations and anions in the gaseous state. So for this process, delta H naught F that is equal to positive, or U is equal to positive energy absorbed during the course of the process. Energy absorbed during the course of the process. So it is observed that if the compound is stable, large amount of energy is needed to dissociate into its constituent ions. So generally we explained, higher the lattice enthalpy of an ionic crystal, the stability of the ionic crystal is high. That means it is occupied by, or it is held together by, strong interatomic forces or strong coulombic force of attractions. But it depends on some factors. Size of the ions, the formation of ionic crystals or the lattice enthalpy is depends on some factors. One is size of the ion. Smaller the size of the ion, lesser is the internuclear distance. Internuclear distance means the bond length is short. Consequently, the interatomic attraction will be high, lattice enthalpy will also large. Smaller size of the atom means interatomic forces. For example, this cation, this is Na plus ion, and this is Cl minus ion, Na plus ion, Cl minus ion. Smaller size means the force of attraction between nucleus and the valence shell electron is maximum, or simply say the cation and anions are held together by strong coulombic force of attraction. Greater energy is required to dissociate the concerned ionic crystal into constituent particles. Second one is charge of the ions. Larger the magnitude of charge of the ions, greater will be the attractive force between the ions. Consequently, lattice enthalpy also high. So these are the two terms. One is smaller size and higher will be the charge of the ion. So those atoms or ions satisfy such type of conditions, and so high lattice enthalpy. And also the ionic compounds have cations derived from metallic elements and the anion derived from non-metallic elements. Ammonium ion NH4 plus ion, both this nitrogen and hydrogen present in the ammonium ion is non-metallic in nature. It is one of the exceptional cases to form and it forms the cations of number of ionic compounds. Cations of number of ionic compounds, ammonium chloride is ionic in nature. So this cation consists of nitrogen and hydrogen, both are non-metallic in nature. Now we are going to discuss the general properties of ionic crystal. These are very important in the examination point of view. First of all, physical state. Normally the ionic crystals are exist in the solid state. X-ray studies of this compound shows that these compounds do not exist as independent molecules. The molecules does not independent exist as independent, not exist as Na plus or not singly exist as Cl minus ions. So these ions are arranged in a regular three-dimensional pattern of crystal system. For example, this NaCl, the cubic structure of face-ended cubic structure of NaCl is drawn like this. So this is the simplest structure of NaCl. So in the lattice points, here represents the Na plus, it represents the Cl minus, it represents the Na plus. Alternatively, Na plus ion and Cl minus ions are arranged throughout the crystal system. The lattice points are held together by a strong coulombic force of attraction. They are exist as solid state, not exist as independent ions. Second one is melting and boiling point. Normally the ionic crystals shows high melting and boiling point because these cations and anions present in the ionic crystals are held together by strong coulombic force of attraction. So we request large amount of energy to break the bond, therefore it shows high melting and boiling point. Solubility. This ionic compounds are polar in nature, therefore they are readily soluble in polar solvents like water, and they are does not soluble in non-polar solvents. Then electrical conductivity. Ionic compounds are good conductor of heat and electricity in the molten state or when it is dissolved in a suitable solvent. When it is dissolved in a suitable solvent, the ionic crystals are dissociated into constituent ions, cation and anion, or exist in the molten state. It exist as Na plus ion and the Cl minus ion. So pre-mobilization takes place. When the electrodes are dipped in this concerned solution, ions move towards the respective electrodes. Therefore, they act as a excellent conductors when it is exist in the solids, exist in as molten state or when dissolved in solid state, when dissolved in the particular solution. In the solid state, we cannot observe any kind of conduction. Why the solid state ionic crystals act as a insulator? Because of the strong coulombic force of attraction between the concerned cation and anion, there will be no mobilization of ion takes place. If there will be no mobilization of ion takes place, means there will be no conduction is expected. And ionic reaction. This ionic compounds, when it is dissolved in a particular solvent, it exists as ions. The exchange of ions between the two different substrate molecules may take place when the reaction may occur. So that the reactions are said to be ionic reaction, and this ionic reactions are instantaneous reactions. Non-directional nature. Ionic bond is always non-directional in nature because the ionic compounds, each ion is surrounded by oppositely charged ions uniformly throughout the crystal system. Therefore, electric field is non-directional. Thus, ionic compound is non-directional in nature. So, these are the some important properties of this ionic or electrovalent compounds. Thank you.